Hello everyone. I ordered this inverter since I intended to set this up later with a small 12-volt solar power supply project. Based on my initial test so far, here are the things I liked about it. Number one, soft start. If you will notice, when I start up the inverter, it takes a bit of time for it to reach its stable voltage. It ramps up from zero to its stable value. I would give it about 5 seconds to stabilize before connecting the AC load. The soft start characteristic is good. Number two, stable output, which is 230 volts AC, 60 Hz nominal. Now 220 volts is fine. I just prefer 230 volts since it gives a bit of a buffer to compensate for some voltage drop should it occur during load startup. I'm also satisfied that it produces 59.6 Hz, which is practically the nominal 60 Hz frequency in the Philippines. Now take note that these are true RMS values, as measured by a Fluke 116, a true RMS multimeter. At no load, it stabilizes at 238 volts, 59.6 Hz, so it may only be a modified sine wave. But the important thing is, it hits the rated nominal voltage and frequency at true RMS values. Number 3. It is also stable at loaded condition. Given that the battery source is just my little Newstar 8 ampere hour battery, the inverter output showed stable voltage and frequency, never varying too far from 230 volts 60 Hz when loaded with my Bax fan. I used my Bax fan here to illustrate this point. I won't be actually using this as a backup electric fan supply, but for important electronic loads only. Now here are the things I thought one should watch out for. The most important thing I believe is that this inverter is not auto volt. It has one and only one specific input rating, and that is 12 volts DC. At the output side, just 230 volts 60 Hz AC. At the input side, this is particularly critical because one might assume that you can connect a 24 volt DC car or truck battery. In fact, connecting a 24 volt battery will likely damage the inverter. There is a warning about this in the user's manual. If you need to connect a 24 volt battery, you must look for a 24 volt inverter, not this one. Then what about these voltage protections mentioned? This is just my personal opinion. I think that it refers to the percent tolerance above or below the rated voltages. For instance, my battery when fully charged had a voltage between 13 volts and 14 volts. The inverter can tolerate that. But 24 volts is not just an overvoltage, it is a technical mismatch. One other thing to be considered is that, although it's said to be protected by a fuse, the fuse is not accessible. This suggests that there are no user serviceable parts. It's not supposed to be opened by a non-qualified personnel. If my inverter stops working after the warranty period, I'll probably just bring this to my neighborhood electronics repair shop. They have the right tools, spares, and safety procedures. Hopefully it won't have to come to that. And last but not the least, using this inverter assumes some basic knowledge about safety of electrical equipment on the user's part. So please follow those procedures and try not to overload this 1000 watt inverter or its cables. Personally, I won't use this for rotating machines like induction motors, pumps, and refrigerators, which have high startup currents. This inverter can run an electric fan, but I won't even bother. It's best used as emergency backup for important electronic loads, laptop, emergency lights, phone chargers, Wi-Fi routers, or something similar that can match the battery source and capacity of this inverter. Overall, I am satisfied with its performance. Thank you for watching.